Welcome to Analytics with Nanx. I'm going to share a quick trick on Power BI where how you can create a relationship with multiple columns. Basically, you cannot create a relationship with multiple columns in Power BI, but what is the solution we have to resolve this issue? That is what I'm going to discuss as part of this video. If you are still puzzled what was this issue, let me walk you through the issue first, then I will come back to the presentation for different solutions we have. Let us go to our Power BI. Now we are in Power BI, where I will just explain the data, what we have. This is the employee information. Employee can be identified uniquely based on this combination, name and city, because John, you see, is in Chennai, John also in Bangalore. Karthik is in Hyderabad, Karthik also in Chennai. So based on these two columns only, you can identify an employee. So these employees applied for some leaves, which is against the last of pay. Basically, all the holidays they have utilized. So whatever holidays they take, which will consider as last of pay. So now you can see John from Chennai, John from Bangalore, Karthik, everyone has taken some leaves. Okay, so that is considered as loss of pay. Now, the thing is, like, we have this table where I need to calculate how much salary I need to pay, because this is the standard salary per month, but these people applied these many holidays, right? So I need to get the per day salary, then per day into number of days they have taken holidays, I will multiply, then subtract from the salary. So this is what I want to do. For that, you might have think like you need to create a relationship. In order to create a relationship, Power BI does not support relationship with multiple columns. In our case, we have employee name and employee name, right? You can see already both the employees are having many relationship. Basically, this employee will identify unique employee based on the city. When I click on control, I'm trying to click on control shift, nothing works out, because Power BI can able to create relationship based on a single column. But now we have two columns to identify an employee, and we need to link these two columns from single table, employee table, and also in a leave table. This is not possible. This is the actual issue we are facing now. This is will not be the case once you maintain employee ID for him 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that if they maintain, and in the leave table, if the respective IDs are there, then there is no issues. But sometimes in your business scenarios, you will not have any IDs. They maintain it in as such in the raw data or business data like this. How can you solve this? That is what we are going to see as part of this video. Let's go to what are the solutions available. Basically, what are the things you can do, like combine the columns. So you can combine both the columns and then you can create a relationship. This is one quick solution. Or you can join the tables and bring whatever required in another table into a single table, right? These are two things I am suggesting you can go for it if it is a even it is a large models. Even there is something like another quick workaround we can do, or the solution I propose is like using a DAX without creating any relationship. You can use the treat as DAX function. There should not be any space. Okay, treat as DAX function is there, you can use it. Basically, once you choose either of the solution, you will get the same results. But once you do combine column join tables, you need to create a relationship, then you can apply the formulas. But in case of DAX, you no need to create relationship, you can keep the tables as such, then you can choose that one, apply the calculations. Let me walk you through all these solutions as part of this video. I hope you will like it. This channel contains a free content for $1,000 or 75,000 INR. Please share this channel with your friends and colleagues. so that these contents will be utilized by someone who needs these. Let's jump into our solution. The first solution is to combine columns. Either you can use DAX or Power Query to combine the columns and then create a relationship. I would prefer to go for combine columns, or Power Query, I will combine the columns. So you can have a new column here, like add a column. Okay, you can say custom column. I will say name ampersand and city. That's it. So you see like John Chen. This can be considered as employee ID. Okay, something like that. Even in leave, you add a new column, custom column, same formula applies over here, name and city. In between ampersand symbol. So this is considered as employee ID. This is for solution number one. So now we will go over here, click on apply, so that you will get a new column here, so that you will create a relationship. Already the relationship has been created. Now employee have unique data, then you will create a relationship. This way you can create a relationship and then you can start writing the formulas. The next solution is using the join tables, how you can create a relationship. Now let us try to remove this, assuming we do not have this employee ID. So we have created the relationship, right? So basically, why you want to create a relationship? When you create a relationship from the dimension table to fact table, it will become a extended table. Then you can use the formulas. What do you mean by extended table? Whatever columns present in these tables, internally Power BI will think like it has came to leave table, right? I mean the main table or the fact table. That is what the extended table. So I'm trying to propose that as another solution. If you do not have the ability to create a relationship using a single column, if you have multiple columns, then join these two tables in the Power Query, then bring those required columns in your fact table itself or any other table. If you have a one-to-one relationship tables, then you can go for any table. But when you have a fact and dimension kind of table, fact meaning a single entity, that is unique entity, will repeat. Whereas in employee, this will not repeat. This is unique. When you have these two combination, which is unique. Fact, this combination is repeating. The same person has taken multiple times holidays, right? That is what a fact table. So here, what I'm saying, this is the second solution. You can use merge queries. Basically, you can bring those columns into the employee table. Let us try to delete these two columns. That will create confusion. Now we are already aware of this first solution, combining the columns. Then you can easily do the things. In the second solution, what you need to do, you can use the merge queries. Merge queries, you choose the leave table and employee table. Here you have option to choose any number of columns. Now I'm choosing two. Here you can see any number of columns, and I would like to prefer you choose the left outer join, meaning like left means always whatever columns or records present in this main table will not be go away. You have whatever matching values, like you can bring the gender and salary as part of this table, that becomes your extended table. Basically, what information is missing? You're missing gender and salary in this table. You can bring it over in your leave table itself. So go for left outer join. In order to understand what are different types of joins, I have made a separate video in my playlist. Just go and check it out in that. So let us click on OK. So this will create us one table for each row, matching rows. It will create one table. For that, you click on here, whatever columns you don't need again name and city, because whatever is matching between two tables, it will start appearing same. So you take whatever columns not in present in your leave table, which is present in your employee table. You click on here. So now you get the employee.gender, employee.salary. So now this table, employee table, is no more required. You can hide it. So you can hide it and you can do the your calculations within this simple table, single table itself, because you do not want to create relationship. This is quite tricky. You will not get what I'm saying, trying to get, but why, what is the purpose of relationship? You are extending the table. So I'm saying you bring those required columns in the same table. This is my second solution. So we will not focus much on this. Let us move on to you. In your case, whatever may be suitable for you, these are my suggestions, and whichever is suits for your need, you can go for it. So let us use our last solution, DAX treat as function, and let me drop these two columns as well from this. So we have employee and leave again. Let us close and apply. We will have this, and using DAX function, how we can achieve the same results. Let us see that. So now we have two different tables. Basically, like in order to save my time, I have written the logics, but I hope it has gone through. No problem. I can rewrite the formulas. Basically, like using a treat as, we can create a virtual relationship between these two tables, right? And then we can create the formula. How we can write? For that, in order to, as we discussed in the beginning, I need to create a formula how much loss of pay they are going to get, actual salary, take home salary for that month, or whatever calculations they are doing. So per day salary, assuming very simple calculation, I will say like for per day, for irrespective of number of days in a month, I will calculate as divide by 30. Okay, that is how most of the organizations also calculate, I think, in order to calculate per day salary. Per day salary, okay, which is sum of salary divided by 30. This is per day salary. Let us have this salary over here, okay, next to the salary. Now I want to bring this loss of pay days here, okay. How I can bring it? Now when I use loss of pay here in this table, it will all, every record will have 10, because this total will be start appearing, because these two tables are not at all related. Okay, so how I can change this formula? Let us remove this one. Instead, let me start writing the loss of pay using some treat as function. So how I need to write this is loss of pay, calculate sum of loss of pay, okay, number of days, okay, this is actually loss of pay is number of days, leave dot loss of pay, comma, bear with me, treat as, okay, treat as. I have made a very detailed video about treat as, how to write. So for you to make it quickly, I'm writing using summarize. I mean, this treat as will create some table. We need a table expression here, basically. So I need to use employee, comma, employee, whatever relationship, okay, number of, any number of columns, employee name and employee city, right? So these two columns, I'm creating one virtual table here, comma. Okay, this is the, so you see the treat as definition, expression, table expression, comma, column 1, column 2. These are whatever you want to look up or map this table, these two columns, consider as treat as, that is the treat as. These two columns, treat as the same column in another table. Okay, it's creating a relationship. So now you say like leave, that is leave dot name, comma, leave city. Okay, so now I have brought this column here. Now ensure that this status employee dot employee name using in your wherever you are reporting. Okay, these two columns belongs to the treetest function. Okay, now I use this LOP newly calculated column here. As you can see from the diagram here in the charts, the Banu Bangalore 2 days, it has came here. John Bangalore 1 day, it has came here. The Uma Chennai, there is no holidays for her, so there is no records for loss of pay. You got what I'm trying to convey here. Now you can again write another formula using using DAX expression, like per day salary into loss of pay minus of five salary, right? Let me write for you, that is take home salary for that month, or whatever, it can be generic also, take home salary, which is nothing but sum of salary, right? We do not create an explicit measure for that. Sum of salary minus per day salary per day salary multiplied by loss of pay. Okay, that is LOP. That is the calculation we have did right now. So which will give me the take home salary? Now there you go. It is correct, because now 5000 minus this into this, that is around 333, which is giving me the correct results. This you can check it out, very easy calculation. 150 into 3 is 450. 4500 minus 450 is 4050. So that is what people will take as a salary on that month. So I hope you understand with simple example. If you do not have a relationship, you have different options for you. Either you can combine the columns and to create a relationship, join columns, you avoid relationship at all, but bring as an extended table. And also you can use DAX treetest function to achieve your desired results. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.